From Universal Studios Hollywood, welcome to Home and Family.
I know, but it's like,
all right, so cute. Look, we're gonna do this workout with Ashley, yes, in our street clothes to show you,
and you can,
just how rugged we are. We're, yes, with celebrity fitness trainer Ashley Borden. She's back. She's gonna show us a full body workout. We're gonna do it in a tiny little space, mm-hmm, so you can do this anywhere because health is so important. You should drop and give me 20.
Right,
just
right
like
now?
That. No, no.
Oh, I mean, sorry. Okay, I was gonna do it. I didn't know. I'm always ready.
You need a mat and some dumbbells.
I was ready to do it.
Advantages, though, I mean, of doing it in a small space.
Well, a lot of people think, I can't do my whole body if I don't have a huge gym or I have a huge outside space. And I say, absolutely not true. You can do your whole workout in this space. It's really not necessarily how much space do you have, but what moves are you doing. Mm-hmm. And doing it efficiently and using the right weight, you have great results.
Can you get the same results, though, that you would get in a big gym?
Yes, of course. You know, the only thing that we are, you know, missing from here is if you were doing, like, high-intensity cardio. Obviously, you can do cardiovascular stuff with more plyometric exercises, yeah, but
sure,
doing your base work for your core work and doing strength work and all of that, all you need is a yoga mat and you need dumbbells and you need us.
Okay. Is it true that you highly recommend doing this right after a rack of ribs?
Yes. Well, I always say eat a rack of ribs first
and then
do
right
your workout.
Into this.
Or actually, you would actually have the ribs after.
Okay.
Yeah. To feed the muscle.
I'll find my ribs after,
yes,
that meal.
To feed the
Thank
muscle.
Thank you, Dean Shermaya. Okay, should we get started?
Yes. All right. So I am, I mean, I know, Christina.
Why don't
you
I get
do,
the girl one?
I know you could do more than 2 pounds of weight.
Yes. I thought those were your earrings that fell on the
girly ones.
Match the pink in your shoes.
All right, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to start on the ground, and we're going to start with hip raises. So I like to do exercises that involve really connecting you to your core before you start, so you feel like you understand. Oh, I like this song.
Right, there we go.
Oh, yeah.
Blurred lines.
Maybe we should just dance. Yeah. All right, so here's what you're gonna do. You're gonna start on the ground.
Okay.
You're gonna reach your fingertips to the base of your heels.
There's a mic pack. You should probably take your mic
pack
off.
Yeah, well, you could do this workout with your mic pack on. Okay. So you're gonna have your fingertips reaching down. You're gonna turn your palms up so your shoulders aren't forward.
Our ceiling is dirty.
And you're gonna drive all the way up to the top through your glutes. Good.
Okay.
All the way up and then down. So we're gonna go 10.
Okay.
And down. Oh, to music.
Robin Thicke.
And down.
Blurred lines. Let's
and
do
down. I feel like I'm back in aerobics. There
you
go.
Are you a DJ over there, Christina?
How do you know?
What is she doing?
9. Last one. All the way up.
10.
You guys are great. All right. So it's about efficiency, right? So we're grabbing the weights and we're going to go to a chest press.
Okay.
Now, I like doing chest press on the floor because it lets you connect to your shoulders driving down as you're pushing all the way up. So I always say to feel like you're kind of breaking a bar if you're holding it above you. You're going to come down all the way up to the top. Squeeze those triceps.
I don't feel like I'm doing anything. These don't weigh
anything.
Those
are too light. But you know what? You know what, though? In real life, you want to use a weight that feels challenging enough.
Give me two frying pans.
Yeah, no. Or you could do some frying pans. Okay,
I have a question. Ashley, I have a question. As you're doing this, do you you want your head rested back? Do you want your head off the ground?
No, head is down. Good question. Head is
Head's
down.
On the floor.
And the other thing that's great about being on the ground is that then you can really connect to your core pulling into the floor.
Do I want feet up?
I would have feet on the floor.
Okay.
So that way you can always feel like you're pulling back into the ground when you're driving all the way up and driving your shoulders down. Very nice. Now I would have you turn over because we want to use efficient movements, and you're going to go into plank. So plank, I love plank because plank gets your entire core and it's safe. So Christina, you'll do the modified version on the knees.
Not that you have to.
Okay, Mark, you do the modified.
Oh, I'll do it.
No, I want you to do full out.
All right, full
out. Palms are up.
I'm not sure.
You're gonna go toe back, other toe back, tushy tight like you're holding a credit card. Yes, and keep your belly button pulled.
Yeah. I can hold that credit card, trust me.
Look at us, we're holding the credit card.
Not for long.
So that's good. So you would hold that and squeeze your glutes really tight. It's an excellent plank position, same thing.
Is it a Neiman Marcus? What kind of card is it?
It's a Black American Express.
It's a Black Amex.
Don't worry about it, it's a Black Amex. Okay. All right, so then we're gonna stand up.
Hey, you set hands up.
Palms up, yes. Palms now, up. Palms up so you have more open shoulders. Now, and also what I would like is for you to squeeze your glutes, please.
Okay.
Thank you very much. He's not holding the credit card.
Give me back my credit card.
Exactly.
You're not going to want it back after that?
Okay,
and then standing up. So now we're going to use more big muscle groups. We're going to do reverse lunge. You're going to grab your weights.
Okay.
Holding the weights up at your shoulders allows you to recruit your core more as opposed to holding them down here. So we're going to hold those big heavy weights up here. You're gonna keep that front heel connected to the ground. You're gonna take a big step back, slowly touch the ground.
Why are we going back? I thought lunges were forward.
We're doing reverse lunges. So reverse lunges are really good for people who have a hard time connecting to their glutes.
Oh.
Yes.
Okay.
So back all the way up to the top. You would do about 10 of these guys on each leg. Nice, Mark. Now, obviously, again, in real life, Mark would be using, you know, 30 pound
weight.
I'd be
using 700 pounds.
Yes, exactly. You know, more weight.
I look like Popeye.
So now we're going to go into a reverse fly.
Okay.
So three different versions of it, right? One is with both feet down, your palms are up, and you're squeezing your shoulder blades, right? So this is getting your back. The next version would be one foot back, slightly, little bit of weight on that back foot, all of your weight on your front heel, good. So you should feel that glute as well. Same thing, squeezing the shoulder blades. And then the most advanced is having that leg all the way out, keeping that foot flexed.
I have a question, where do you want to be looking? Because I would tend to
straight
want to
down.
Be down. So not out.
No,
right?
Straight down, because we're looking at the alignment of your head in line with your spine. Okay. Look at this. Who's in the advanced one?
Oh, show
Come
up.
Come on! Look at that! Look at that! Give her the 10. Give her the...
There you go.
Oh my God.
I can't believe you did that.
So the good thing about this type of work, what I like to do with my clients or you guys, if you were doing it at home, that's good.
That's actually very good.
Is that you can set a timer and go through this circuit as many times as you can within 10 minutes.
I got worked up a sweat.
That's what I'm saying.
That's so great. Yeah. I feel it all over.
It's a full body. You're burning calories. You're working your postural muscles. You're working your core.
You're working balance.
You're working glutes. Whole body, short period of time, very effective.
You're also working your credit line.
That's right.
Using this for a full body workout. As you saw here today, go to our website, hallmarkchannel.com/homeandfamily. You can also visit AshleyBorden.com for more workouts like this. Thank you so much,
Got lots
Ashley.
Of them.
I like it's a compressed, compact.
Me too. It's
I like
about
it.
Efficiency.
I do feel like I worked out. It's
Up
great.
Next, Joe Mason's here. He's going to tell us how your child may be at risk for identity theft.
Yeah.